हेलो चिल्ड्रन, आई होप यू वेंट थ्रू द चैप्टर द साइंस फेयर. यू एंजॉय द चैप्टर? यस चिल्ड्रन, यस. सो नाउ लेट अस स्टार्ट विद द एक्सरसाइज चैप्टर 3.7 एट द साइंस फेयर. यस चिल्ड्रन, सो चिल्ड्रन यू हैव गॉन थ्रू द चैप्टर ना. सो यू अंडरस्टूड दैट साइंस फेयर इज़ एन अपॉर्चुनिटी फॉर स्टूडेंट्स टू अप्लाई द साइंटिफिक मेथड टू कंडक्ट इंडिपेंडेंट रिसर्च. यस चिल्ड्रन, so now I will give you some meanings, new word meanings that you have to repeat neatly, properly in your copy, and then you have to, after that you have to write the answers for the given pointers. Yes children, come on, open your textbook, page number 80. So first of all, let us discuss the answers, and then I will send you the PDF, okay? And some answers we will discuss that you have to write on your own, find out the answer, take the help of Google and search and find out the answer. Okay, so question number one is, answer the following questions. Question number one, that is, what two basic rules were followed in the science fair? Remember children, basic rule, the first rule was everything should be handled by students. Second, the entertainment booths and refreshment stalls had to have a scientific base only. Yes children, remember these were the two rules to be followed. Okay, now question number two, that is, how early did the preparation for the science fair begin? Okay, how early children? The preparation for the science fair began a couple of months in advance. Okay, so next is, how was the committee formed? Remember, committee of parents and teachers were set up to look after all the work of the fair. Along with parents and teachers, some students were also given the chance. Some students' representatives were also taken on the committee to give them a first-hand experience of managing big programs. Yes. Okay. Now move to question number D. That is, what themes did the committee identify? You have to write the name, the theme. Themes means children, that subject, the main idea of the this exhibition. Yes, main idea of the science fair. The themes identified by the committee were, remember the names? Yes. So they were plant, animals, properties of substances, energy, science in our everyday life, latest news from the world of science, and food and nutrition. These were the themes. Okay, now move to next one, question number, that is question number E1. Yes, what is E given? That is, how did the students prepare for their stalls or presentations? How the students prepare? Children, this answer you will get in your textbook. Okay, so that is, how were the preparations? Stalls were allotted to many groups of children. Each group selected a topic, or we can say an idea, from the chosen themes. The young scientists began collecting a lot of information about their topic using science textbook, then visiting library and through the internet. Yes, so they shared and discussed this information in their groups and decided the exact activity for their stall, deciding whether they would build and display a model, then or give a demonstration, or present their project through posters, or simply exhibit a collection. So these were the preparations. This all is given in a textbook. Yes. Okay. Now question number F1. What did Mr. Gizare appreciate the most? Okay. What is that thing? So Mr. Gizare appreciated the fact that in most of the stalls, visitors could try out the various science experiments and models. This was the thing. The visitors could try the various science experiments and models. Okay, they could try out. So this was the thing Mr. Gizare appreciated. Okay, now we will move to next one, last one, that is G. What did the Clean Brigade do? Clean Brigade do. So the Clean Brigade, what did children? So the Clean Brigade members made rounds of the fair, spreading the message of cleanliness, and they had vowed, they promised to keep, vowed means they had promised to keep the school premises spick and span, that is, spotlessly clean during the fair. So this they did. Okay, now we will move to question number two, that is, make charts to show the important points to remember while making. Okay, you have to make charts or to remember while making that is graphic presentation and oral presentation. What all things are needed? What are the important points to be remembered while making presentation? It is two types of presentation. That is graphic presentation. That is and graphic means children what? In the form of a drawing or design, picture presentation or oral presentation. Okay, what things are needed? So this answer also I will give you that you have to write. You can also take the help of textbook and you can frame your answer. Okay, you can go to page number 76 children. Okay, there it is given. It is on graphic presentations and oral presentation that you have to write. Small points you have to frame and you have to write. This answer I will give you. Okay, now we will move to question number 3. That is, relate the themes of the fair to your science textbook by writing the relevant chapter, chapter numbers under each theme. Understood? Relate the themes of the, subjects given of the fair to your science textbook, just present your science textbook, 6th standard, by writing the relevant chapter numbers under each theme. Okay, this you can do taking the help of your textbook. Okay, now we will move to question number 4. Find in your science textbook the topics of the stalls handled by students of 6th A. Okay, write the page number. This also you can do. Okay, from your science textbook, the topics of the stalls handled by students of 6th A. Okay, you can take the help of science textbook and you can search the answer. Now question number 5. That is, what themes would you like to add to the themes given in this passage? Here it is, what themes would you like to add to the themes given in this passage? So themes, we just have seen the themes given in this chapter. So along with these themes, what would you like to add to this given themes? Okay, so along the given themes, what would you like to add? Okay, children, it is up to you. What themes would you like to add? Like you can add how to make a lemon battery. Okay, you can also add like build your own telescope. Okay, then you can find out why honey crystallize. So in this way, you can add more themes. Okay, according to your knowledge, according to your wish, you can add more themes other than the themes given in the textbook. Okay, this also you can frame your answer. Next is question number 6. Imagine you are visiting the science fair. What other stalls apart from the ones mentioned here are you likely to find there? Okay, imagine that you are visiting a science fair. Now you imagine that. Now here you imagine that you are in your annual exhibition where you are visiting our science models. Okay, do you remember science model you participate? Some of you must have been participated, na? Okay, others must have visited your friends stalls or models. You must have went through the models. Yes, children. So remember that. Okay, so here it is. Imagine you are visiting the science fair. What other stalls apart from the ones mentioned here are you likely to find there? So just imagine, okay, what extra stalls may be, means you remember, other than the stalls mentioned in the textbook. Okay, try to list at least 5 more stalls. So you just find out, children, so stalls, or you can write the names of 5 models which you remember, okay, the last year science exhibition, which you remember, that you can write here, okay, any 5 names of the 5 models you can write here. Okay, remember the science exhibition and you just write the 5 names. Okay, now question number 7th is, using your imagination and information from other sources, describe any one stall in detail. Okay, here is using your imagination, information from other sources. Okay, you can take the help of Google. Okay, other sources, describe any one stall in detail. Okay, here you can take the help of Google or just imagine and find out also from other sources. Also take some help of some science textbook or take the help of your parents or your teachers and describe any one stall in detail. Any one stall in detail, you can frame your own answer and you can write there. Take any topic and you have to describe about the stall, that is whatever is given there, or you can take the prize winning stall also. What is the aim of that? Why that experiment is conducted? Why that model is presented? What is the name of the experiment? What is the aim of the experiment conducted there? What materials were used? Okay, what is the output? All these things you can describe. Okay, children, this you can do. Take any topic and you can describe that. Okay. Okay, now we are moving towards question number, which one is over? Seventh one over, na? Yeah? Yeah, stay of solid detail is over. Okay, eighth one is, choose a question through your own observation. Choose a question through your own observation. Try to follow the scientific method to find the answer to that question. Okay, you according means you observe your surrounding and you just find out one question and try to follow the scientific method to find the answer to that question. Take the help of your teacher or parents to set up the experiment. Now, children, here see, you come to page number 79. Okay, this is page number 79. Here you can see the scientific method. Remember, children, scientific method. Here, what was the question? Like here it is given. Observe what is around you. Ask question. Okay. Then you have to like question. Which is the question here? Why does the fridge magnet stick to the fridge door but not to the kitchen platform? This question is given here. Now, according to you, okay, or you observe your surrounding, you just find out one question and you, according to scientific method, you have to, what you have to do? You have to, what is the question given? You have to set one experiment, set up the experiment. Okay, children, then you have to write the what is the aim of your experiment, name of your experiment, what materials are used. Okay, then here the same way you can frame the set up the experiment. Try this. Okay, this you can do. Okay, so this, try this one, okay, with the help of your parents or teachers or with the help of Google, just search a question and you have to, according to scientific method, you just in the form of that flow chart, you can frame the experiment. Okay, children, just try out. Okay, now we are moving towards the last question, that is visit a library, find and read the biography of your favorite scientist. Now, children, biography means a person's life story. Now, here you have to find out the life story of your favorite scientist. Okay, like biography means a person's life story, especially the published one, which is the published one. Okay, so your life story of your favorite scientist. Okay, children, you can go search in internet, take the help of internet. The famous, you take, just take the famous Indian scientist. Okay, there are so many scientists, famous scientists in India who have done lots of noble work for the, then they are very famous the whole over the world. Okay, whole world they are very famous. Just go to find, just search, you will get many Indian scientists. Don't need to go anywhere else. Okay, Indians are very famous. Indian scientists are there. They have done lots of research. They are very famous. They have invented so many, discovered many things. Okay, like we have C.V. Raman, okay, Nobel Prize winner for physics. He worked on scattering of light. And you have Homi Bhabha. Okay, next is Vikram Sarabhai. He was the father of India's space program. Okay, and very own. Okay, A.P.J. Abdul Kalam, Indian president. Okay, he was the he was an Indian president, A.P.J. Abdul Kalam. He worked as an very famous. You know APJ Abdul Kalam. Okay, he worked as an aerospace engineer. Okay, children, so any of your favorite scientists you take and you just find out the biography, frame the biography. It will be a very interesting thing, what sorts of work they have done, why they got the Nobel Prize, whatever prize they received. Okay, what work they have done. Okay, what they have invented. You find out about the life story of that famous Indian scientist, children. Okay, your favorite Indian scientist. Yes, children, you will get it, you will enjoy. Can share with your friends. Okay, find out, share with your friends. You can make a PPT, you share with your friends. Okay, it will be a very inspiring activity. Okay, children, just do that. Okay, so now over now. So this was the last question. Okay, so now we will stop here. So this was the end of our unit 3. Okay, in the next video, next period, we will start our last unit, that is unit number 4. Okay, there will be a, I think first chapter is a poem, that is Sleep My Treasure. Okay, children, so I hope you enjoyed the chapter, Science Fair. Okay, so you have to complete your work neatly, clearly you have to complete. Okay, neatly, very neatly, write each and every word properly. So children, there is no problem of any problem here, because everything you are having in front of, you are watching in your, this PDF in a laptop, mobile, so there is no disturbance, nothing. So you can copy down properly. Please, please children, without making any mistake, you have to copy down each and every...